From the financial capital of India, it is turning into a fire capital of India. We're talking about Mumbai here, the infrastructure of which is crumbling by the day. And yet, many believe that it is one of the most livable cities in the country. But statistics will prove otherwise. 4 people died and 14 others were injured after a fire broke out in Crystal Towers in Parel in Mumbai yesterday. In a massive CNN News 18 impact, the Mumbai police arrested the tower developer Abdul Razak Ismail Sosaparivala after it was found that the building lacked basic infrastructural details, such as firefighting equipment, that further aggravated this particular situation. CNN News 18 has also accessed an RTR reply by the Brihan Mumbai Municipal Corporation, which admits to more than 2,500 fire incidents in Mumbai this year alone, which comes down to a shocking 10 incidents every day, resulting in the death of 24 people and injuring 122 people in the last 8 months. The question here is, where is the dignity of life or death as far as Mumbai is concerned? The Dean of KAM Hospital, Avinash Supe, confirmed that a total of 24 victims were brought to the hospital, out of which 4 were unfortunately dead. Here is what he had to say.
Total 24 victims were brought to KAM, out of which 4 were dead, 1 female and 3 male, out of which 2 we have identified and 2 we are not able to identify because they are really charred bodies. We have also got few bones along with that, but they may be probably part of that, but we are checking about it. And in addition, there were 20 victims were brought as patients. All are very stable. Most of the patients have mixed kind of an injuries, mainly breathlessness and the oxygenation which is at low. But now with their oxygenation, they all have improved and they are stable. Few patients have minor burns.
Chaitanya Mangure is joining us live from Lower Parel in Mumbai. Chaitanya, for a city that we call the financial capital of our country, this is turning out to be a fire capital of the country. 2,549 fire incidents in 7 months alone. Where is the compliance? Where is all the checks and balances as far as basic infrastructure is concerned, basic fire safety mechanism is concerned? What is going on in Mumbai?
Well, Chetty, that's really a question that the BMC needs to answer. And when an RTI was filed to know as to how many such incidents have taken place in the recent years, the data for this particular year, that is 2018, is quite shocking, because if I have to talk about the numbers, it's about 2,500 incidents of fire and short circuit. Something similar to what happened yesterday has been happening for over 2,500 times here in Mumbai. And people have been losing their lives now. 24 people have died in such incidents in Mumbai. So it is a huge number in 7 months. So this data is only from January 2018 till July 2018. So only in 7 months we have seen 24 deaths in Mumbai due to the incidents of fire and short circuit. And where I am right now, the same building, Crystal Tower, where the incident took place, in which 4 people lost their lives. This building does not even have an occupancy certificate, despite of which the developer had asked the occupants to stay here, and they were staying. There was a notice sent in the year 2016. In fact, the building was ready by 2014. Occupants started staying there, and after 2 years, a notice was sent to them saying that you need to vacate the place within 7 days as it does not have an occupancy certificate. And on the other hand, when the firefighters went inside yesterday to see if they could use the internal firefighting system, they noticed that it was non-operational, because of which it took a lot of time, in fact, for them to carry all the external fire equipments to the top floor and then control the fire, which consumed a lot of time and also increased damage as well as casualties. And talking about these numbers and what the Mumbai Fire Brigade and the BMC is doing, I'm also joined in by RTI activist who has filed this particular RTI, Shakil Ahmed Sheikh. ये आपने आरटीआई फाइल किया था, नंबर्स देख के पता चलता है कि बहुत सारे इंसिडेंट्स हो रहे हैं मुंबई में. सो मेनी फायर एंड शॉर्ट सर्किट इंसिडेंट्स ओवर 2,500. व्हाट वाज द क्वेरी एंड व्हाट वुड यू लाइक टू सी अबाउट दिस रिप्लाई, क्योंकि आपके पास 2013 से लेके अब तक का डेटा आया है.
मैंने जो मुंबई फायर ब्रिगेड को एक आरटीआई फाइल किया था 2012 से लेके जो है 18 तक, अब तक कुल कितनी मौतें हुए, कितने फायर इंसिडेंट हुए और कितनी जो है उसमें इंजरी हुई है. तो अब तक जो है 2012 से लेकर अगर आप देखेंगे तो 29,000 के आसपास इंसिडेंट हो चुके हैं, और अभी जो 2018 में जो है टोटल जो है 25,549 फायर इंसिडेंट हुए हैं, जिसमें जो 24 लोग मारे गए हैं और 122 जो है इंजरी हुई है। तो कमला मिल होने के बाद भी जो है इन्होंने सीख नहीं ली, सबक नहीं लिया, और ये जो आग लगने का सिलसिला कंटिन्यू चालू ही है जो है। और इनके पास अगर देखा जाए तो जो आज हाई राइज बिल्डिंगें बना तो दे रहे, लेकिन वहाँ तक पहुँचने के लिए इनके पास लैडर्स नहीं है, क्योंकि मैक्सिमम इनके लैडर्स की जो है हाइट है जो 90 मीटर्स है, और अगर आप देखेंगे मुंबई में 100 एंड 100+ जो है फ्लोर राइज बिल्डिंगें बन रही है, तो कहीं ना कहीं ये फायर ब्रिगेड के लिए बहुत ही बड़ा चुनौती का काम है।
बट ऑन वन हैंड व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट द इक्विपमेंट्स ऑफ द फायर ब्रिगेड, वेल द फायर ब्रिगेड सेज दैट वी हैव आवर इक्विपमेंट्स अकॉर्डिंग टू द इंटरनेशनल स्टैंडर्ड, एंड एवरी टाइम अ परमिशन इज गिवन टू एनी हाई राइज बिल्डिंग इट इज मेड मैंडेटरी दैट दे शुड हैव देयर ओन इंटरनल फायर फाइटिंग सिस्टम इन केस ऑफ सच इंसिडेंट्स।
You know, Chaitanya, I'll point out something. You should get this reaction from that RTI activist who is with you as well. There are a lot of buildings in Mumbai which do not even have an occupation certificate. By the virtue of these buildings not having an occupation certificate, a lot of compliances are not met with, which is why it doesn't have an occupation certificate. Then why is it that the BMC is still taking taxes from them? This is the duplicity at its best.
Taking taxes. In fact, the BMC had also provided water and electricity to this same building. In fact, if we have to talk about the building, which does not even have an occupancy certificate, the BMC's Department of Building Proposal sends a notice saying that you need to vacate the building. On the other hand, the same BMC's Water Supply Department had provided water connection. The Department of BEST, which provides electricity, had also given them electricity connection. So all these things were done despite of them not having an occupancy certificate. So it is very clear that once the residents had water and electricity, they never thought that the building does not have an occupancy certificate, because most of the residents I've been talking to are saying that the builder told them that it is only that there are some taxes that are pending and to be paid to the BMC, and that is the reason the occupancy certificate is pending, and once the taxes are paid, they
why should the BMC even collect taxes from a building that does not have an occupation certificate? Chaitanya, we must get this answer from the BMC. This is an absolute urban planning mess example. This chalta hai attitude of Mumbai. Mumbai life goes on, Mumbai never stops, Mumbai never sleeps. But the fact of the matter, Chaitanya, you're a resident there as well. The fact of the matter is, do Mumbaikars really have a choice? Are they left with a choice but to just go on with their lives like this?
Well, there is no option left, because this is not just not one incident. We have seen several incidents happening, including Kamala Mel, and we have also seen several other incidents as well. In fact, whenever such incidents happen, there is no accountability set, and that is the major problem over here, because every time there are deaths due to such incidents, it is only the people who own that
Chaitanya,
particular
just
building.
Hold on, just hold on. Apologies about interrupting you there. Former Chief Fire Officer Pratap is joining us now on the phone line on this particular story. Mr. Pratap, good morning and thank you so much for joining us. My first up question to you is, there are ample buildings like the Crystal Tower in Mumbai that do not even have an occupancy certificate. Mumbai, as we know, is a vertical city. It's not a horizontal city. You have many high rises over there as well. There's a problem of space. My question is, if the fire compliances and checks and balances are not in place, why is it that the BMC continues to take taxes from these people who are occupying these buildings? Why do they end up supplying water? Why do they end up supplying electricity as well? You should just stop doing all of that and not allow people to even reside and, you know, take the developer to task. What do you have to say about that? This is just one example of many other buildings in Mumbai that do not have these compliances in place.
I can only tell you in this case, as a firefighter, we generally do our duty irrespective of what is there, what is not there. That is what our main aim is, to save life and fight fire, basically. Why the municipal corporation does this and that is not our purview, really speaking, point of view.
Your lives are at stake as well as firefighters. Your lives are at stake as well as firefighters.
NOC or otherwise, then subsequently, OC part of it. Now, this recent fire, Crystal Fire, is a good example part of it. I personally feel that when the particular building comes up, it is the duty of the particular local ward officer
Correct.
To understand exactly whether the structure is legal, illegal. Simply giving a notice is not going to serve purpose. It has to be followed, and then the logical end has to be done. If suppose it's an illegal building, it is to be kept vacant all the time until the particular, you know, OC is taken, the, all the firefighting systems are in place. Now the point over here is simply giving in the notice doesn't serve because now people are going to go in. The reason may be there, no humanitarian reasons, all those things. But the point here is now there are so many cases. Mumbai Fire Brigade has lodged in the court, but there is no persuasion. The good lawyers are not fighting the particular case, and then it is pending for a long time.
Okay, no, that's a very important thing that you said. You said there are many cases that the fire brigade has lodged in the court of law as well, which means one thing. You know, as hats off to people like you who give up their lives, who actually put their lives on risk and go and salvage these people when fires are breaking out in several different buildings as well. But why haven't you tried to engage into a dialogue with the concerned authorities as to first, if the fire compliance is in place and then the fire breaks out, it is fair enough. It is your job. But when you don't have fire compliance, your lives are also at risk.
Yeah, that is true. But ultimately, when we are the department, you know, we have to save lives. That is the main aim of our department. Now, what we are trying to understand is we to avoid this particular situation, everyone has to come together. All the departments, all the people, senior, all the departments come together, have another sort of an upsell saying that this we cannot tolerate this particular thing. If the building is illegal, it has to be treated as illegal. No occupancy or nothing, nobody should go in and stay over there.
That means there's an underlying nexus, right, between the developers and the corporators as well.
Yeah, but the point is all the stakeholders, whether it is government, whether it is the one who are controlling, that is the municipal corporation, so also the other agencies like police, to come together and see that people, if it is found illegal, simply giving a notice, as I said once again, is not going to serve. You have to come to a conclusion that we see that the building is either demolished or otherwise, it is not allowed to be occupied at all.
And as far as the pending cases in the court are concerned, walk us through what are these cases, because it seems like you all have filed some cases, but you all are not finding any headway as well.
No, this is as per the recent law which has been there, Maharashtra Life Safety and Fire Prevention and Life Safety Act measures, which came into force in 2006. And according to that, there are provisions wherein if the particular occupier owner doesn't comply with the firefighting measures, right, which are required, so that we given a notice after 120 days is given to him as per the law. Then subsequently we lodge an FIR, and then subsequently it goes into court of law. Now the point over here is if there is no pursuance of the particular case at all. No, it's just pending
pursuance
there.
Pursuance from whose end?
Pursuance, but we lawyers, competent lawyers from the municipal corporation, so that the logical end is there. Till today, we don't have any particular prosecution.
It basically boils down to the municipal corporation not doing anything about it.
Yeah, that is what we want, basically, so that the deterrent will be there. Otherwise, this sort of things will always go on in Mumbai. So many high-rise buildings are there. The fire brigade inspection cell is so is not provided with the proper proper
equipment?
Aid as well. No, equipment is not the criteria. See, we do have
financial
an equipment. Not financially. We require enough particularly good lawyers to fight our cases.
And you're not getting any kind of lawyers who are willing to fight your case pre bono?
That is not happening. Basically a competent lawyer, because the other party is going to engage a good lawyer.
That's right. The developers will be having the financial bandwidth, you're saying, to hire good lawyers. And that's where the issue is getting stuck as well. I get your point. In your many years of career as a chief fire officer, walk us through the kind of negligence that Mumbai buildings are seeing at this point of time, right from the year 2012 to 2018, that RTI activists filed a reply and noted that 29,000 deaths have happened only because of fire breaking out like that.
the point, the very important point is in the commercial building part of it, because of, again, the LPG was in the main cause for the most of the injuries or death part of it. Another important point is we have seen that most of the high-rise building which has been given OC, once the OC is given, the maintenance part of the firefighting system was not there. The pumps never worked at most of the time. So what happens over here is then the law came up, but there was some improvement, and then because of that, the certificate in B form is required to be given to the particular fire service officials. There was some change in it, but again, it is sometimes we found the responsibility is given to the particular person, the occupier owner. He engages licensed vendor. But many a times what you find is the certificate is just merely given. And most of the time...
So now, okay, got it. Mr. Pratap, why don't you just tell me who is to blame for this entire mess, this particular mess that the maximum city, the financial capital, which is turning into a fire capital of India, who is to be blamed for all of this? And OC is given on what grounds is the OC even given when the fire safety checks are not being done?
The very important point, I can give you is that the cell which is there, inspection cell which is there, which doesn't have any particular the staff to handle this particular house. So many high-rise buildings are coming up at everywhere, right? So unless and until competent inspection officers are inducted and subsequently properly trained and then subsequently separate cell, is created. Now, what is happening is same people are doing the inspection part of it. They are so much overburdened. And then again, they have to go from one pillar to post to understand the legal aspect of it. That's another thing. No, unless and until a good, stable and competent cell, inspection cell is created, separate cell, again, I'm trying to tell you, this sort of an non-compliance part of it can have a logical end.
All right. Thanks so much, Mr. Pratap, for joining us. That was the former chief fire officer joining us, saying that how a separate cell is required to just maintain the checks and balances and compliances so tragedies like this do not repeat again. Chaitanya Mangure is joining us live from Lower Parel now in Mumbai. Chaitanya, we've got the RTI activist also with us. More than 2,500 fire incidents in Mumbai in 2018 alone, and about 29,000 from the year 2012 to 2018 as well. There seems to be no dignity of life or death as far as the financial capital of this country is concerned.
Well, that is a fact, Chetiv. That is a sad fact that the Mumbai people of Mumbai have to face. On the other hand, I would also like to highlight one point over here, that Shakil also tried to obtain an RTI stating that how many times an audit has been conducted or how many buildings do not have an audit and are still occupying the premises in Mumbai. The reply that was given to him was in one single line. And let me have the reply from him itself. आपने जब ये पूछा था ऑडिट के बारे में तो आपको क्या रिप्लाई आया था?
जो मुंबई फायर ब्रिगेड ने जो ऑडिट का जो रिप्लाई दिया उन्होंने कहा है कि बीएमसी फायर ब्रिगेड जो है ऑफिसर्स जो है ऑडिट नहीं करते हैं. जबकि मैंने नंबर्स मांगे थे हाउ मेनी बिल्डिंग्स हाउ मेनी वार्ड्स में हुए, तो इन्होंने सीधा से एक रिप्लाई दे दिया कि मुंबई फायर ब्रिगेड जो कोई भी ऑडिट नहीं करती है. तो मुझे मालूम है बीएमसी महानगर पालिका और जो फायर ब्रिगेड ऑडिट नहीं करती है, उनके पास ऑडिट जमा होती है और उनकी जिम्मेदारी ऑडिट करवा के लेना. तो कहीं ना कहीं ये जो मिसगाइड करने का मिसलीड करने का काम करिए बीएमसी जो है और मुंबई फायर ब्रिगेड जो है. और इसी तरह से अगर आप ये देखेंगे आज जो क्रिस्टल टावर है, आज ये 100 मीटर से भी कम जो है डिस्टेंस पे है जो महानगर पालिका या बीएमसी का वार्ड है जो है. और यहाँ पे बिल्डिंग एंड फैक्ट्री डिपार्टमेंट कर क्या रहा था जो, अगर इसको ओसी नहीं मिली तो इलीगली रह कैसा रहते जो है. तो बहुत ही एक बड़ा सवाल है कि आप जो अगर जैसा अजय मेहता कहते हैं कि जो है कुछ आरटी एक्टिव्स और जर्नलिस्ट जो है ब्लैकमेलर हैं, तो मैं अजय मेहता जी से पूछना चाहता हूँ कि आपको 50 मीटर 100 मीटर पे जो आपको एक क्रिस्टल टावर दिखा नहीं और इतना बड़ा इंसिडेंट हो गया कि चार मौतें गई हुई है.
Let me just highlight what Shakir is trying to show over here. In fact, he's just trying to point out that at the other the building, which is on the other side of the flyover, that is the ward office of the BMC. That is the ward office. I'm standing right below the building where the fire incident took place, in which four people died yesterday. And it is right opposite to the ward office of BMC. So the question is, was the BMC sleeping from 2014 to 2016 when the people had occupied this particular building and they were already staying here? Why did the BMC wait for all these 2 years? Were they completely unaware that this building was being occupied? Because the BMC says that it came to their notice in 2016 and that is when they served notice to all the 58 occupants, including the developer and the architect. But what was the BMC doing from 2014 to 2016 is again a question that the BMC officers have to answer, because this is just on the other side of the road. That is the BMC ward office and this is the place where I'm standing. It's the building where four people lost their lives and the BMC says they were unaware, and when they got to know, they served the notice. And even after that, from 2016 to 2018, they're watching it, but no action is taken. And after the
and
fire
from
incident,
right across the road,
the
they're watching this.
The residents have been asked to leave the building immediately. So this is in fact the sad fact of the BMC and the people of Mumbai.
You know, people of Mumbai, who are the highest tax-paying citizens of the country, ought to know this kind of apathy, which is on display by the richest municipal corporation in the country, which is the BMC, led by the Shiv Sena. They have not broken their silence as to what they're doing with all of that money that they have. They need to come out here and break their silence on CNN News 18. They are not taking our calls. They are not responding to our messages as well. This itself shows the amount of apathy that the largest municipal corporation is displaying, and the fact that Mumbai's taxpayers' money is being taken for a ride every day in the maximum city. Thank you so much, Chaitanya, for joining us with all those updates right there. And of course, the former chief fire officer who joined us as well. We're taking a very short break right here on CNN News 18. National News continues on the other side.